see like I'll be in the middle of my set and I'll do some constant tension. So as I'm doing those small little reps, it's keeping constant tension on my pec. And I've found that it's just, for me, it's a better workout. I didn't always do that, but it's been helping a lot lately. I've been seeing a lot of gains through doing that. Man, I wish I didn't have all these tattoos, but they kind of, they represent my story, I guess, you know? I had all these by the time I was like 20, 21. I got a teardrop when I was 17, I think. But that was just for someone I lost. And then I hated it so much when I was sober, because I got it when I was drinking and taking Xanax, that I tried to burn it out. If you see, I put 2 cigarettes out on it when I was a little older. But now it's just a line. But yeah, it looks, what can you do, man? I wanted to get it removed with a laser, but they said it's too close to my eye, so they had to surgically remove it. And I just haven't done it. It represents who I used to be, you know? And I've always had like this battle within me, the light side and the dark side. So I've got like a demon on this shoulder and an angel on this shoulder. And it's kind of just, you know, I got into a lot of trouble when I was younger. Recently I have, you know, really decided to turn my life around. I got baptized and I just been trying to be a better person all around, you know, kinder, more patient. You know, I don't break any laws. I stopped cursing, not because the Bible says not to curse. I did it more because starting at a young age, we know that cursing isn't right. We're told this by our parents, but we start rebelling and we start cursing, right? Well, let me just speak for me. I'm only speaking from my experience. I started cursing and it was like an act of rebellion, and that kind of started this whole thing to where now I'm breaking rules, breaking laws, it turned into criminality. I struggled with addiction. Those words have been used a lot to like when people are angry or to hurt people, and it's just like the negativity associated with those words, as well as like the whole act of rebellion is just something I chose not to do anymore. So I still stumble every now and then. Yeah, I still curse at times, but I immediately recognize it and I apologize, ask for forgiveness, and then I do my best to correct it and keep moving forward, you know? Because that was just so naturally, it was like ingrained in me. It was part of my vocabulary, part of my speech patterns. And now it's gotten easier. You know, my girlfriend, she doesn't curse anymore either. And it's just like a special thing between us and God, you know? I just kind of go light, I don't go too crazy. I'm just trying to really get warmed up, basically. I just feel my body out. A lot of people I know have like workout plans where they write stuff down and they do certain muscle groups on certain days, which is legit. I've done it both ways. It's just I'm getting back into this after not doing it for a while, and I kind of had my routine down, but now I've just kind of been listening to my body and just kind of go from there. For a beginner, it'd probably be best to, you know, have a regimen down and follow it to a T, you know, but to each his own, I guess, you know. For me, coming to the gym is like a natural antidepressant, gets my dopamine going. And the way you feel after a workout, man, it's just, or the way I feel, is just unmatched, man. This is a big hobby of mine, and I just wanted to document it so I had something to look back on, you know?
Sorry, man. Go ahead, man. All right.
Thank you. I usually do that, like starting with a higher weight and going down and raising my reps as I go, you know? It's weird because I've never filmed my workouts. Talking to the camera, but whatever. It's all good. Really, I just want to be able to look back day at a time and see the progress. Always wipe your machines down. Sometimes I'll see people sweating all over the machine and don't wipe it down. I just got chest, all right. Usually I'll spend a lot more time on each muscle group, but I gotta work today, so I don't have that much time. So I'll start with the bicep curl, the machine. Dude, I just do what I know. I just do what I know works. I'm gonna do 65 today. I like to put the seat lower. I get that full bicep. And then I hold it. I hold it in the middle and really flex it. Really getting that good pump.
Good, good to see you.
Really get that burn, you know? I'll do a few more sets of these, and I'll probably go hit some free weights. Alright, so I just ran into one of my friends. She works here now. It's good to see people, you know, doing better with their lives and trying to do right, you know? That's the vibe nowadays. Change, positive change. Thank you. happens now. As long as there's a spot open. I'm gonna start with 35 dumbbells, 35 pounders. I don't do tons of reps, but I make the reps. When I go down to lower weight, I'll do more reps. Right now, I'm just gonna do a rep, hold it, and
just get like some mass.
protein. So it's like 1,200, 1,500 calories per shake. So I think that with like a balanced diet and eating a lot, I'm gonna have to eat more because I'm trying to bulk up. So you guys can be along for the ride. Let's see how it goes, right? I'm gonna go down to 90 per arm now. Usually goes for me. I'm not doing any legs today. I also I learned another good exercise. All you need is like something that's waist high. Put your arms on it, both arms. I'll show you. So in between, like I'll do a set of tricep extension, and then in between, after that, in between those sets, I'll do what I'm talking about. This one. I usually start at like 60. Sometimes you gotta warm it up, but sometimes my elbows get bad. Gets up here. The little exercise that I was just doing on the bench, that gets my lower tricep, like in here, right there. So the machine gets up here, and then what I was just doing gets down here. So I like that. Spectrum, you know, you got the dark side and the light side, and I've learned that whatever side you feed the most is the side that you're going to be on. So I've just tried to feed the lightness in me, you know, because deep down I have a really good heart, I have a good soul. I was just so lost, and all the things that I was doing, the way the people I chose to surround myself with, you know, starting at a really young age. But I'll get more into that at some other point. This is just about working out. Too. the days I work, I also don't like to go too hard because I work at a cheese company. So up here in Wisconsin, I have a cheese company. I'm from Florida. If you would have told me I was gonna live in Wisconsin working at a cheese company, I would have told you you're crazy. But that's what I do right now. So my job's super physical, so it's like a workout in itself. Some days, like when I'm off, I'll work out for 2 or 3 hours, you know? But right now, I'm almost done. I'm gonna do a couple more sets of something else, and then I'm gonna head out. But yeah, it's good. I'm gonna do the seated rows. Probably start at like 150 maybe. I haven't done it at this gym because I usually work. I live on the other side of town. My girlfriend lives on this side. So I'm gonna see. I don't know. I usually was doing like 120, 130, but I feel like I've gotten stronger since then. So we're gonna see. Oh yeah. Feels good, but that's a lot of weight for me, you know? I might go down a little bit. I found that listening to my body is the best.
You gotta be patient for this whole fitness thing. It's a journey, right? I say this because I'm trying to tell myself this as well. It's like, this is a journey, this takes time, you know? My former self is like, instant gratification, I want it now, I want the results I want now, I want the body I want now. But it's like, dude, you got nothing but time. Like, slow down if you need to. Go less weight if you need to. Like, don't hurt yourself. Don't hurt yourself. You're gonna be not working out for who knows how long, right? So, I just need to remember that sometimes. I felt a lot better. How late it was.
I've been through such gnarly stuff in my life, in my past, that I don't sweat the small stuff anymore. As long as I'm on this side of the wall and I'm doing right and I'm trying to live how God wants me to live, everything else is peanuts.
I just want that final piece for everything.
Like, man, I lived my life in the darkness for so long. And like, bro, if I could have just done it sooner, I swear. Oh, saved myself so much pain, my family, my loved ones. Oh man,
God, because I know God was upset with me.